Alzheimer's disease, AD, is a chronic neurodegenerative disease that usually starts slowly and worsens over time. It is the cause of 60% to 70% of cases of dementia, a general term for memory loss or decline in cognitive ability, enough to interfere with daily life. Patients may not recognize family members. They may have trouble speaking, reading or writing. They may forget how to brush their teeth or comb their hair. Symptoms can also include disorientation, easily getting lost, mood swings, becoming anxious or aggressive, loss of motivation, not managing self-care, and behavioral issues. Eventually, they need total care. This can cause great stress for family members who must care for them. Risk factors include increasing age, 65 and older, genetic factors, smoking, a history of head injuries, depression, or hypertension. Alzheimer's is not a normal part of aging. The cause of Alzheimer's disease is poorly understood. Several competing hypotheses exist trying to explain the cause of the disease. 1. The genetic hypothesis, the genetic heritability of Alzheimer's disease, based on reviews of twins and family studies, ranges from 49% to 79%. 2. The cholinergic hypothesis, which proposes that AD is caused by reduced synthesis of the neurotransmitter acetylcholine. But it has not maintained widespread support, largely because medications intended to treat acetylcholine deficiency have not been very effective. 3. The amyloid hypothesis, which suggests that extracellular amyloid beta, A-beta, deposits and forming amyloid plaques are the fundamental cause of the disease. Support for this hypothesis comes from the location of the gene for the amyloid precursor protein, APP, on chromosome 21. Together with the fact that people with trisomy 21, that is Down syndrome, who have an extra gene copy, almost universally exhibit at least the earliest symptoms of AD by 40 years of age. 4. The tau hypothesis, which proposes that tau protein abnormalities initiate the disease cascade. Normal tau is required for healthy neurons. However, in AD, tau clumps together. As a result, neurons fail to function normally, and eventually die. 5. A neurovascular hypothesis has been proposed which states that poor functioning of the blood-brain barrier may be involved. The blood-brain barrier is a highly selective semipermeable membrane that separates the circulating blood from the brain and extracellular fluid in the central nervous system, CNS. It allows the passage of water, some gases, and lipid-soluble molecules by passive diffusion, as well as the selective transport of molecules such as glucose and amino acids that are crucial to neural function, while preventing the entry of lipophilic potential neurotoxins. So, disruption of the blood-brain barrier allows blood plasma containing amyloid beta, A-beta, to enter the brain. 6. Loss of neurons connections. Neurons can't survive when they lose their connections to other neurons. As neurons die throughout the brain, the affected regions begin to atrophy or shrink. No treatments stop or reverse AD progression, though some drugs can offer relative symptomatic relief but remain palliative in nature. These drugs are usually prescribed for mild to moderate AD symptoms. Donepezil, or Aricept, for severe AD as well, rivastigmine, or Exelon, galantamine, or azadine, and memantine, or Namenda, for moderate to severe AD,